By law, blood is supposed to be free in both private and public health facilities. This is intended to ensure that everyone accesses quality and sufficient blood whenever the need arises, irrespective of their financial ability. The Minister of Health is, however, shocked that most times people have to pay for blood, especially during surgeries. Speaking during the launch of the preparatory meetings for the 11th African Society for Blood Transfusion Congress, Health Minister Jane Ruth Acheng raised concerns over the continued commercialization of blood transfusion services.
What can we do to address the issue of stopping the sale of blood? Blood is life. It is life. I know National Water says water is life. It is also life, but blood is life. If you don't have blood and you require blood, you will die.
Acheng also expressed an urgent need for strong legislations on blood transfusion and distribution services, believing that the only way to curb this vice is by enacting a law on blood.
We need a law to regulate blood in this country. There was an attempt to put it in the tissue transplant bill, which will soon be signed into an act, but we saw it could not fit there. It needs its own law.
If you don't donate blood, then there will be no blood in the hospitals. So people must be aware that if you sell blood, you are going to be prosecuted. If you don't donate blood when you are supposed to donate, then you are not doing a service for your country.
Currently, the country needs at least 457,000 units of blood for its citizens. However, with the ever-increasing refugee population of about 1.6 million people, the demand for safe blood is estimated at 473,000 units.
So there is a failure to identify blood as a precious national resource. That is another challenge. And it affects resource allocation. There is lack of clear strategies on donor management, e.g. donor health and donor retention.
This indicates a deficit of over 100,000 units since the country currently has only about 330,000 units of safe blood. However, Professor Isaac Koja says there is a need to solve the challenges at hand to increase the country's blood supply.
Problems like they are in the developed world, a very old population which cannot donate but which requires a lot of blood. So we have to prepare ourselves for that. And it is going to become a challenge.
WHO guidelines state that a country is considered self-sufficient in safe blood if it collects a tune of at least 1% of its population. Meanwhile, Uganda will host the 11th African Society for Blood Transfusion Congress due to take place in March 2024. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.